The old Flume Bridge used to transfer 140 megalitres of water per day. Now the whole region uses around about 300 megalitres per day, so nearly half the water supply come over that broken old bridge. We could have stopped the leaks and we could have patched it up, but New Zealand is on the ring of fire. It's seismically active. There are earthquakes every day. And so, yep, the old concrete box was going to end up in the river. And then we went, that's not right. We're not going to get resilience and longevity by fixing the bridge up. So working with our client, we said, hey, we need to replace the bridge. We started to think about how can we put a bridge in there to work with nature, not work against it. Working with the regional council, working with our client, and working with iwi, which is the Indigenous people of New Zealand, communications was very important. Making sure everybody was brought on that journey with us was key. The park users, the walkers, the canoeists, everybody was kept informed. When the project was finished and we gave the site back to its owners, there was a ceremony held with the local iwi, and an incantation and a blessing was given, which we call a karakia. That was very special, very moving. The karakia focused on the water and the flow of that water, which is a source of life. The Kaitoke Bridge in engineering terms is simple, but the location, the whole thing together, the team of people that had to come together to solve this problem. We must find ways to innovate, to be sensitive with our environment, to come up with solutions for our communities, and to make sure that the legacies that we leave don't harm the environment. This was built with a 100-year design life. There will be lots of generations that will have the water supply protected by what this team did and achieved.